We're going to stay on that global front with our next guest to discuss recent controversial comments from France's President Emmanuel Macron. We're joined now by Obianuju Ekeocha, the founder and president of Culture of Life Africa, as well as the author of Target Africa. Uju, welcome back to the show.
Thank you, Catherine. It's always great to be here.
It's great to have you. First off, let's get started. Let's take a look at those controversial comments that President Macron recently made.
I always say, please present me the lady who decided, being perfectly educated, to have 7, 8, 9 children.
What's your reaction to that?
Wow, this is, speaking as an African woman, one of many children of my mother, this is quite an insult. It's very patronizing, I'd say, and even in many ways derogatory for women who want to have a career on one hand, but who also want to have a large family on the other hand. So it's a terrible thing, I think, for a world leader like President Macron to go out on a major stage like that with all eyes on him to make this kind of comment. What does that say to women and the women who feel that they should have the choice? You know, if they wanted to have a large family and a career at the same time, they shouldn't have to give one up for the other.
And as you mentioned, Uju, you do come from a large family yourself, one of six, I believe, from
yes.
Nigeria.
Yes.
What would you want to say to President Macron and other people who hold those ideas about what it's really like to be in a large family?
I mean, people are doing it. My mother was never a stay-at-home mom, not even once she had a full career in Nigeria as a teacher. But she wasn't, it wasn't even anything extraordinary because a lot of her friends had, you know, 7, 6, 9, 8 children, as Macron had said. Show me. President Macron, I'll show you my mother. I'll show you my mother's friends. I'll show you my aunties and our family friends who decided that they wanted this large family because to us, a child born, you know, even as the international world is looking at this African baby born as an unnecessary increase in population, but for us, every baby born is a new member, a valued member of our community of love. So I'd tell him it's possible, it's done. People have done it in the past. People are still doing it now. One of my very close friends is one of 9. And it's a normal, you know, it's a normal family. I grew up knowing my siblings, loving them, having the support of not just my parents, but also lots of brothers and sisters around me, my own parents. My dad particularly comes from a large family. So for us, that's a gift because that means I have so many aunties and uncles who love us all the time and who are very much a part of our lives.
That's a beautiful gift. What do you think, Uju, the pro-life movement can do to counter this misconception that women cannot advance in their career and education and have a large family?
It's an insult to women. Mm-hmm. You know, women are strong and resilient, and women can do exceptionally well in whatever career they choose. But also, on the other hand, I believe that God has given us this gift of, you know, maternity, this gift of femininity that we, you know, find is perfected in motherhood. So women can have it. We can, you know, we can go out and be a doctor, be a scientist, be a nurse, but still go home and be that mother, you know, the mother who is irreplaceable within the family and be able to give love to children, give birth to children, give love to children and raise them, you know, and raise them in the right and in best way possible. So women can do it. Women have done it. Women continue to do it. So we say, please stop for those who have this agenda and those who are pushing women really hard, trying to get us to think in just one way, one, you know, they want a monolith. But no, not all women want to give up family. Not all women want to remain childless in order to have the career. We want to have it all. And I say they should let us.
That's beautiful. And these comments that President Macron made were made at a Gates Foundation event. And I know that you are familiar with Bill and Melinda Gates. What are they trying to do in Africa? What is their agenda?
This is something that worries me because a lot of people who know me know that I came into the pro-life movement because of an open letter to Melinda Gates that I had written back in 2012 when she was pushing for a family planning movement around the world at the time. Now, it has progressed from that because at that point in time, we saw she was working on her own. She was moving this whole contraception thing on her own. Now, it's so much bigger. Why? Because Bill has suddenly joined her. It is now a joint effort by these two very powerful people. They are a real life power couple. Now they have this initiative, brand new initiative called the Goalkeepers initiative, and that's exactly, as you said, where President Macron was, where he made the comment. It was at a goalkeeper's event, and twice, in fact, very recently, we have heard a very similar message in a very similar statement, which is this, that African women's fertility is a problem, that African women's fertility cannot go hand in hand with economic development. So there was once when Macron had made the statement, but also the editor-in-chief of Vox.com went on Twitter and made this horrible comment about the biggest problem in the world being the increasing population in Africa. And this was really on the heels of a podcast that he had done with Bill Gates about the goalkeepers event. So there is an agenda there which is really unfolding, and we're watching it.
And what kind of message does that send?
It's awful. I mean, this is population control. This is eugenics. That I think it's a very eugenic message that they are forming now. But it's also a very sleek message because they're putting it out, not like before, where perhaps a population control message is undesirable or it's ugly and people don't like it. But now they're putting it out as something really nice, something sleek, in this very beautiful packaging. I would say goalkeepers event, so beautiful, so posh, lots of important people there, and President Macron says this. Of course, he goes to Vox.com. They're having this podcast that a lot of people listen to, and he puts out the same messaging. And I think we're just going to see more of that. And it's something that I think everybody should watch out for, the goalkeepers event and the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation and what they are doing with their friends.
Well, thank you for your voice and for your witness. Obianuju Ekeocha, Culture of Life Africa and author of Target Africa. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, Catherine.